Hi, and welcome back. Resonators, especially waveguides, became my obsession in the last decade. And nowadays I find myself avoiding every other sound synthesis method when making music. In this video, I'm going to show you a unique technique that makes patching complex waveguide systems easier. Probably the most famous physical modeling concept is Karplus-Strong synthesis, which is just a fancy name for a comb filter, which is another fancy name for a delay with feedback. The idea is to tune the length of the delay to match the wavelength of the pitch we want to play and excite the system with something. The feedback coefficient determines the release time of the sound. The length of the delay is responsible for the pitch, while the timbre is defined by the excitation signal. In a classical Karplus-Strong patch, the exciter is mostly a short burst of noise, and the system sounds typically something like a guitar string. This model is only somewhat accurate if we assume the string is excited exactly in the center and both ends of the string are fixed identically. If we excite the string, waves start to travel in both directions through the string. As the wave propagates, it loses energy, so the amplitude of the wave attenuates. When the wave gets to one end of the string, it reflects. If the string is fixed at this point, the reflection of the wave has the opposite polarity. If we assume that the behavior of the string is linear, then we can say that the wave travels through any point of the string periodically, and the strength of the wave is going to be attenuated exponentially. Let's say this in practice and build a string using bidirectional waveguides. In a bidirectional waveguide, we have a wave that travels from left to right and another one that travels from right to left. The final waveform is the sum of these two traveling waves. The two ends of the string are referred to as the nut and the bridge. We need to simulate these two. We know for sure that if the nut and the bridge are fixed, then they invert the wave. So we will have to multiply the wave by a negative number. We also know that wave propagation and reflection require energy, so we have to calculate with energy loss. The wave must attenuate, so we will multiply it by a value between 0 and minus 1. Let's take a pair of delays. One delay represents the time the wave requires to travel from left to right, and the other represents the time the wave requires from right to left. We need to add the nut and the bridge to the system. The nut and the bridge multiply the waveform by a negative coefficient, creating a closed loop. How to excite this system? If you want to hit the string at an arbitrary point, you have to set up another pair of delays. One of the delay times should match the time it takes the wave to reach the bridge, and the other should match the time required for the wave to reach the nut. I'm not building this setup this time, since that would make the video too long, and my goal is to give you a simple and efficient method for waveguide-based sound synthesis. If you're interested, you can download all the patches from our Discord, where we can also chat about different synthesis methods. The nice thing about bidirectional waveguides is that they can be combined. You can couple multiple waveguides into a larger system, which is able to create a wide range of harmonics and inharmonics. The point where waveguides meet and interact with each other is a junction. Probably the most commonly used junctions are the Kelly-Lochbaum junction and the normalized scattering junction. Technically, they can be derived from reflection matrices like householder matrices, but you don't need to go that deep to use them. In my patch, I've included both the 1 multiply Kelly-Lochbaum junction and the 3 multiply Sried variant of the normalized scattering junction. These sound great and offer a lot of flexibility, but patching such systems is not something I like to do. I desperately wanted to be able to simulate the behavior of coupled waveguides in a simple system, like the Karplus-Strong. Since I figured out that the root of scattering junctions come from scattering matrices, and I already knew that these matrices are Allpass systems, my attention turned towards Schröder Allpass filters. Schröder Allpass filters have been used in early reverb algorithms. They are a mixture of a feedback comb and a feedforward comb. Both use the same coefficient, but with opposite polarity. Whatever coefficient you choose between minus 1 and 1, the output won't change its magnitude. This property makes these filters ideal for reverberations, since you can put as many into a feedback loop as you want. So why not throw one into a Karplus-Strong and detune it? That should be something useful, not? I think it is. While this doesn't exactly match the physical properties of coupled strings, it's surprisingly close in sound and much simpler to patch. The feedback parameter of the Allpass can be thought of as the reflection coefficient of the scattering junctions, and the delay time is the length of the coupled resonator. And we don't have to stop at one coupled string. We can put another Allpass into the Allpass filter, creating a nested Allpass filter setup. Nesting is simple. Just build a single Schröder Allpass filter. Copy the designer and paste it inside itself. Patch it right after the delay and you've already nested an Allpass filter into an Allpass filter. By routing controls to the outside, you can have a comfortable system to work with. The only question left is the hit position. In the bidirectional waveguide, we used a pair of delays to define the position of the excitation on the string. I didn't mention that this setup can be simplified to a single delay. Using a simple delay in an inverted feed-forward comp structure, we can send the same impulse into both delay lines and get the same result. In this simplified resonator, this method is usable. This setup has extremely rich sonic capabilities. Every sound in this video's background music was generated using this method. I've only found one paper mentioning a similar technique, but never seen it in this context. If you like this video and would like to see more content like this, then like or leave a comment. You can also join our Discord for further discussion. You can find the link in the description. Thanks for watching. Bye bye.